We're here with the new Ping G Iron, and just like the new G Driver, there's plenty of new technology wrapped up in this new club head. So what do you really need to know? Well, first off, you need to know that it's a game improvement iron, but it's a really good looking game improvement iron. The top edge is not nearly as thick as what we've seen on a number of Ping irons in the past, which really improves the cosmetics. It doesn't look stupidly offset, and Ping say the offset is pretty much the same as what's in the G30, but they've worked on the transfer in the hosel just down here to make it look cosmetically a lot cleaner and a lot better. There's also a new steel. So Ping have used the 17-4 stainless steel for years, but this they're calling the Hyper 17-4 stainless steel. And what does that actually mean? Well, they actually heat treated the steel to improve the strength of it so they can make the club face a lot thinner. And it also improves the bounce back, so the springiness of the steel as well. In the cavity, you can see that we have the CoreEye technology, which Ping used in the G-Max iron. What does that do? Well, that basically means that the club face can act like a diving board. There's some mass in the center, but it's really thin around the edges, so that when you hit the golf ball, it's basically springing and rebounding back. Ping say that because of the new steel they're using and because of that CoreEye technology, you're basically improving the ball speed by about 1.25 miles an hour, which equates to over 5 yards in distance, which is quite impressive. What else is there to know about this new G iron? Well, you should know about the tuning port in the back of the cavity. So in the past, Ping have always used a tuning port because it allows them to weight the golf club to lots of different lengths and to different players. But in the past, that tuning port has always been attached to the club face. So obviously with the new club designs where you want the club face to spring, you can't have that port attached to the club face. What Ping have actually done is they've moved it back from the club face and they've made it deeper. And that basically gives you two benefits. One, it gives the space for the club face to be able to spring into. And also it means that you've got the weight further back from the face and lower and deeper. So the MOI of the golf club is improved as well. Now, the other thing you really should know is that Ping have got this new AMT shaft, which is a really interesting shaft. It's a ascending mass technology shaft. And what that basically means is that they are trying to match your clubs at both ends of your sets of irons. So the shorter irons, which are closer to your wedges, they've got heavier shafts, but incrementally, they become lighter into the long irons. So that matches the weight of the shaft a lot more closely to your hybrid. Those lighter shafts in the longer irons mean they're easier to be able to launch and easier to be able to square the club face up. And I've given them a try and they're actually really, really impressive. That pretty much is the new G iron from Ping.